Today on Winning Golf, we have a very exciting team competition featuring young golfers from Chester County, Pennsylvania. These young golfers represent an international organization called the FCA. What is the FCA? Find out next on Winning Golf. Got a chance, could it be? It's in the cup!
Wow! Winning golf, that's what we play.
It's in the hole!
Working on that short game each and every day. I'm near the green again, that's where the action all begins. Cause with Winning Golf, everybody wins, that's right, everybody wins.
Hello everyone and welcome to Winning Golf, the show where everybody wins. And today, from the spectacular Applecross Country Club, Winning Golf is thrilled to bring you a very exciting team competition featuring two groups representing the FCA of Chester County, Pennsylvania. And leading these two wonderful FCA teams are two wonderful coaches, Coach Gibson and Coach Neef. Paul, let me start with you, my friend. First of all, it is great to see you. And Paul, in our last two seasons, your South team has been victorious. So I'm guessing that you have your team ready to try for a third Winning Golf championship this year.
Oh, absolutely. We're going for a three-peat this year. Nothing holding us back. Got the team ready to go, nice and focused.
Well, thank you, my friend. Good luck to you and your South team. And Coach Neef, welcome back to Winning Golf. Now, Coach, your team came up a little bit short the last two seasons, but I've been watching them warm up. They're focused and I think ready to bring home their first Winning Golf Championship trophy.
Doug, we are coming home with the victorious Carolina Blue golf team. Right, guys? We are there. We will win this year.
Well, thank you, Coach Neef. Good luck to you and your North team. Now, let me turn to my FCA teams. Simple question for you. Are you ready to play some Winning Golf?
Yeah!
Boy, I love that enthusiasm. Now, here's the deal. Our first skills challenge is a fun group putting contest where all of you will putt from 25 feet at the same time. Now, some of the golf balls could collide into each other, but here's part of the fun. One of you will win a beautiful prize. You ready? How about a Winning Golf logoed bag towel and a title of staff hat with the Phillies logo on it? Pretty awesome?
Yeah.
What a prize. All right, let's get ready to putt. Okay, our two FCA teams are ready to putt from 25 feet. Ready? One, two, three, putt. And here they come, 12 golf balls heading towards the cup. One looks very close. It's in the hole. We got another one in the hole. What a great putt and what a way to start our FCA day. Well, Matt Ober, congratulations. That was a terrific putt. That's the second year in a row you rolled it right into the heart of the cup. So as promised, here are two wonderful prizes. Matt, I hope you had a great time in the contest.
I absolutely did. Love to start it off strong from blue.
You got it, my friend.
Yeah.
Well, as you can see, these two FCA teams are ready to play some Winning Golf. And the great news is this. We still have lots of exciting contests ahead of us. But first, let's take a tour around today's championship facility, the stunning Applecross Country Club. Applecross Country Club, located in beautiful Chester County, Pennsylvania, is already well known for exceeding expectations when it comes to serving its members and guests. And believe me, 2023 is no exception. In addition to the championship golf course, Applecross provides a series of amenities unmatched in the region. Amenities include a first-class golf instructional facility, gorgeous practice facilities, which now include top tracer technology, an indoor pool, an Olympic-sized heated outdoor pool, a kids splash zone, tennis and basketball courts, a sport court area for the youngsters, indoor and patio dining, a state-of-the-art all-season sports pavilion featuring a 10,000 square foot fitness center, and just recently, Applecross completed a stunning wedding and banquet facility called the Gardens of Applecross. But believe me, the amenities don't stop there. Applecross is also home to a majestic three-level, 15,000 square foot clubhouse. The first level provides the membership with world-class men's and women's locker rooms, as well as a brand new club storage facility. The third and top level became home to the extremely popular Eagle's Nest Bar and Lounge. The Eagle's Nest provides the membership with a delicious bar-style menu, indoor and outdoor dining for up to 60 guests, numerous large screen TVs, plus an expansive covered deck with breathtaking views of the 18th hole. And in 2021, on the second level, Applecross added a stunning new golf pro shop, as well as an exquisite new family dining area named Mulligan's. Without question, this beautiful new clubhouse is one of the true gems in the entire tri-state area. The pristine golf course, which opened in July 2010, blends into a landscape that reveals breathtaking views of sparkling lakes and rolling countryside. Wetlands and water features grace the surroundings on 14 of the 18 holes. One thing is for sure, lead designer Michael Nicklaus, the youngest son of Jack, greatly enhanced the architectural heritage of the Nicklaus name with this gem.
We have seven sets of tees that's with yardages ranging from 7,000 to just over 5,200. We have sets of tees that offer availability for many different age levels and ability levels. So it's a great design, and Doug Ray, our superintendent, has a golf course in perfect condition. So practice facilities are great. We have two putting and chipping greens, one just behind me right by our gardens. We also have a full range driving range with the Eric McLuhan Golf School attached to it as well. On that driving range, we have Top Tracer, which is what the PGA Tour uses for their data analytics that you can use whenever you're on the driving range.
The Nicklaus arrival at Applecross also kicked off in an inviting multi-club membership program, offering championship golf by Nicklaus, Palmer, and Reese Jones. For example, a membership at Applecross Country Club provides you with full privileges to Tallamore Country Club in Ambler, Pennsylvania, as well as the Tallamore Golf Resort and Mid-South Club, both located in Pinehurst, North Carolina. Members in the Tallamore Family Network have 100% reciprocity with all four facilities based on their category of membership selected. Membership options are designed to fit your lifestyle and budget. They include social, casual, and full golf, as well as junior, young professional, executive, and super senior memberships. Today, world-class golf and club facilities grace each of the properties that are part of the Tallamore family of clubs. If you would like to learn more about this unique multi-club membership and possibly join the warm and welcoming Tallamore family, please call 484-692-1010 or check out the website at applecrosscc.com.
Get ready for the Winning Golf Skills Challenge. Winning golf where everybody wins.
Now let's meet our players, starting with the FCA North team in blue. Coach Bob Neef, Matt Over, Harry Trainer, Justin Over, Priscilla McHugh, Heidi Krug, Isabel Tickner, and the FCA South team in the red shirts. Coach Paul Gibson, Zach Sebra, John Haney, Otto Dietrich, Nate Kiley, Kendall Masters, Riley Masters. Our players are set for Doug's FootJoy lesson tip and shoe contest. FootJoy, the number one shoe in golf.
Today's FootJoy contest comes to you in three parts. Part number one, I'm going to share with you three setup keys that I promise will help your chipping game. Part two, Harry Trainer is going to put my chipping tip into action. And part three is the FootJoy contest, where all of you will get to hit a chip shot and at the same time compete for an unbelievable prize. You ready for this? How about a gorgeous pair of FootJoy shoes?
Yeah!
What a great prize. So let's talk about chipping. Here are my three setup keys I use every time I attempt a chip shot. Number one is my ball position. I make sure my ball is right in the middle of my stance. Key number two is my hand position. My hands are slightly ahead of the club head. So this would be even with the club head. This would be behind the club head. My hands are ahead of the club head, okay? And they stay ahead right through impact. Key number three is my body weight. About 60 to 70% of my body weight is on my front foot, and it stays there the entire shot, okay? So to summarize, it's pretty easy. The ball is in the middle, and your hands and weight are forward. Sound like a plan, everyone?
Yeah.
Awesome. Well, before we get to the very exciting FootJoy contest, Harry Trainer, come up and help me out, please. How about a nice applause for Harry?
Thank you.
All right, Harry, great to see you. So let's get your setup, all right? Ball in the middle of your stance. Okay, good. Then I'm going to ask you to place your hands ahead of the golf ball a little bit. And then I'm going to ask you to move more weight on your front foot than your back foot. It stays there the entire shot. Okay, now I'm going to step back with these wonderful FCA teams. When you're ready, let's see if we can't hit one near the pin, okay? Well, look at his shot, everybody. What a great touch by Harry Trainer. Harry, that was a thing of beauty. It doesn't get much better than that. Hey, I hope you learned a lot today.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Hendricks. That was a great tip.
You're quite welcome, Harry.
Thanks.
Well, everybody, you ready to try to win a pair of FootJoy shoes?
Yeah!
Let's go.
Our FootJoy contest is all about the perfect setup for this challenging chip shot. John Haney is up to the challenge.
And that's about pin high. Okay, John, well done.
Nate Kiley listened well to Doug's tip.
Beautiful stroke, Nate. Well done. Well done. That's a great stroke, buddy.
Justin Over hits a beautiful chip to just under 4 feet from the pin.
This could be very close. Justin Over with a sensational shot.
But Priscilla McHugh hits this winning golf shot to just 2.5 feet to take the round.
But look at this touch by Priscilla. That is a thing of beauty. Well done, Priscilla. Good job. Good setup. Well, Priscilla, congratulations. Your perfect setup led to a great chip shot. So now you'll be lacing up a beautiful pair of FootJoy shoes, the number one shoe in golf. Priscilla, I hope you enjoyed the FootJoy contest.
Yeah, I had a great time competing in the FootJoy contest, and I'm really excited to see my new shoes.
Well, thank you, Priscilla. Well, as you can see, the action is heating up. So we come back. These two FCA teams will be battling head-to-head in the Winning Golf Skills Challenge.
What do you do when you take the lead? Run with it. Redefine it. Push further. Get it wrong to get it right. Don't just lead the pack. Pull others to the front. Rise up. Stand out. Step forward.
Finally, a tour-level launch monitor for every golfer. The Bushnell Launch Pro. Technology used by virtually every tour pro to know their numbers and improve their game. Personal launch monitor with unmatched accuracy and performance, both indoors and out. Improve your game, boost your confidence, lower your scores. The Bushnell Launch Pro. Accuracy above all.
Prizes and tee gifts for the Winning Golf Skills Challenge provided by Titleist Golf Balls. Titleist, the number one ball in golf. And by Per Golf, training systems for the tour player and the rest of us striving to get there. Per Golf. Scotty Cameron Putters, the choice of champions. Scotty Cameron Putters. And Shine Nutrition, health meal replacement shakes, energy teas and treats. Just what your body needs. Shine Nutrition. Doug Hendricks' wardrobe provided by the Greg Norman Collection. Greg Norman, performance by design.
I'm here with John Haney from the FCA South team. And John, in our first round of competition, we have a 45-foot chip shot from a fairway lie. So my question is, what club will you be choosing for this challenging shot?
Doug, I'm going to use my 54-degree wedge.
That is a great choice, my friend. Well, I think both FCA teams are ready, so let's get round one underway.
Our Winning Golf Skills Challenge will showcase our players' short game skills with some challenging shots in three preliminary rounds. Each round, our players earn points for their team. Our fourth round is worth double points, and we up the ante in the fifth round with triple points. Then our top two players for each team will compete in an up and in competition worth 25 points to their team. Round one features this 45-foot chip shot from the fairway. Priscilla McHugh has this shot in her bag.
Might come off the hill a little bit, Priscilla. Let's see if it does. Coming back a little bit. And that's a beautiful shot, Priscilla. Well done.
Nate Kiley chips his ball to 5.5 feet.
And that's a great touch, Nate. Your setup's important, right?
Yeah.
Harry Traynor earns some points for the North with this effort to 5 feet, 5 inches.
That's a beautiful touch by Harry Traynor. Well done, Harry.
John Haney's effort looks great at 4 feet, 2 inches.
That's coming down towards cup pin high. Great shot by John Haney. Well done.
But the South's Kendall Masters earns 5 points with this gem to 2 feet, 9 inches.
Below the wind and everything. Well done, Kendall. I love it.
After one round, the South leads the North 11-4. Round two tests our players' putting skills with this fast 30-footer that Otto Dietrich handles well.
Will the speed make it? It's got a chance, Otto Dietrich. Wow, Otto Dietrich.
The South's Zach Zebra has the read on this putt.
I like the speed. Zach Zebra's got a chance. It's in the cup. Wow, another Drano for Zach Zebra.
He drains it.
teams are playing Winning Golf today.
The North's Justin Over says if you can do it, so can I. He sinks it as well.
He's got a great line, Justin Over. It's in the hole. What a comeback putt and more Winning Golf from Justin Over.
Harry Traynor adds more points for the North.
Down the hill from 30 feet online. Harry Traynor, it's in the cup. Harry Traynor drains it. Well done.
And check out the South's Nate Kiley. He sinks it too.
If it gets there, it's got a chance. Nate Kiley, it's got a chance. Nate Kiley, it's in the cup. It's in the cup. What a putt by Nate Kiley. Wow, that's Winning Golf right there.
And takes the round for his team in a playoff. After two rounds, the South has a 19-11 lead over the North. Round three is a 40-foot ball toss with a left-to-right break. The North's Heidi Krug has a good feel for the distance.
It's got a chance to go in, Heidi Krug, right over the lip of the hole. Heidi, all right. Well done.
Riley Masters answers back for the South with this toss to just 6 inches.
She's got the line, she's got the speed, and look at this touch by Riley Masters.
The North gets scoring from two more players, Justin Over.
This could be very good. Justin Over moving from left to right. Will it get there? That's the question. It's right on the edge.
And Matt Over, whose toss finds the bottom of the cup.
This one's got a chance. Matt Over moving from left to right. Will it get to the cup? That's the question. It's in the hole. Another Drano with a ball toss from the North team.
But the South's Zach Sebra says, hold on a minute. He drains it as well and takes the round in a playoff.
Zach Sebra, it's in the hole. Zach Sebra drains his toss, and that is Winning Golf for the South team.
The South is just ahead of the North, 26-19. Now it's time to check out what's on the tee with PGA professional Doug Hendricks, brought to you by Thermal Solutions, a dynamic mechanical insulation contractor presently celebrating 17 years of excellence. Thermal Solutions.
I'm on the tee with Phil Over, the director of the FCA here in Chester County, Pennsylvania. Phil, wonderful to see you. Our third year together as a partner with FCA and Winning Golf, and it keeps getting better and better, my friend.
Boy, no kidding, Doug. You know, those 3 years have been great. We've created incredible memories and times for the kids that are involved in the show, but we've also been able to make our local community around us much more aware of what FCA is doing in the community with and for them.
Well, that's awesome. Now, I know about the FCA for many, many years, but a lot of people don't. So tell us what the FCA is, Phil.
So we love our acronyms, but FCA is the Fellowship of Christian Athletes. You can tell by the name, spiritual organization. We do get a lot of coaches and athletes that don't want to engage on a spiritual level, and that's okay. We'll mentor and disciple them on a physical, a mental and emotional level. Mm-hmm. And we'll do that by using disciplines that you would want to see all around you. Things like integrity, serving, excellence, and teamwork. Mm-hmm.
Well, all great values to live by, my friend. Now, for all the programs you have, for Winning Golf, for a lot of other events that you have, camps, you need some financial help. How can people help you with the FCA and support you?
Yeah, no doubt, Doug. So FCA is a true nonprofit, and so we count on those donations to do what we do. The easiest way would be to donate right locally to my.fca.org/Phil Over. Those donations, you can make a monthly pledge or a one-time donation. They all stay right here in Chester County in the Philadelphia area to allow us to do the other things that we do. And, you know, Doug, talking on that teamwork thing, I would be remiss if I didn't make you aware of the team that was here today. Mm-hmm. So we had Service Master Cleaning, Service Master Restore, Body and Soul Fitness, Ex-Golf of Chester Springs, Mr. Sticky's Sticky Buns, and even Mentality Barbers in Fraser, who did my hair, and making me look right on camera is a tough job. So thank you to everybody.
Phil Over, you have a wonderful summer haircut. Let me add that. I'll see you next week on the tee. I'm here with Heidi Krug from the FCA North team. And Heidi, round four is the double point round and worth 30 big points. We also call it Winning Golf's moving day. So my question is, Heidi, is the North team ready to make a big move here in round four?
We ready to make a big move?
Yeah!
Well, they sound ready to me. So let's see which team hits the big shots here in round four.
Round four is the chance for players to earn double points.
The North strikes first. Justin Over has no problem with this 15-yard short pitch.
Good try, Justin. Well done.
The South answers as Nate Kiley pitches his ball to just 5 feet away.
With a sand wedge, and look at that touch by Nate.
Otto Dietrich adds 6 points for the South with this effort to 4 feet away.
And look at that touch by Otto. Well done, Otto.
Priscilla McHugh hits a tremendous shot for the North to just over a foot and a half.
That is a thing of beauty. Well done, Priscilla.
But John Haney gives the South a commanding lead with this winning golf shot to 10 inches from the hole.
Look at this touch by John. That's winning golf by John Haney.
After four rounds, the South is up 46 to 29.
I'm here with Priscilla McHugh from the North team. Priscilla, your team is down 17 points, but this is the triple point round and potentially worth up to 45 points. So Priscilla, my question for you is this. Can you lead your North team to a big comeback here in round five?
Yeah, are we ready, team?
Yeah, let's go!
Well, the excitement is building, so let's see which team shines in our triple point round.
Round five, we're triple points and can shoot one team up in the standings. Our players are challenged with this 30-yard uphill pitch from the rough. The North's Isabel Tickner pitches her ball to less than 10 feet away.
That is a beautiful chip shot, Isabel. It might come back a little bit, and that's a great shot.
Otto Dietrich grabs 3 points for the South with this pitch.
That's a nice stroke, Otto. Well done, buddy.
John Haney continues the roll for the South.
This could be very close when it's done. John Haney, well done.
Matt Over takes 9 points for the North with this shot to 6 feet.
He's got a chance. Beautiful shot, Matt. Well done.
Harry Trainer of the North puts more pressure on with this gem to 5.5 feet.
That's some winning golf right there. Well done, Harry.
But check out the South's Riley Masters. At 4.5 feet, that's 15 points for the South.
Might come back off the hill. Here it comes, Riley. Still coming, Riley. Let's see. Let's see, Riley. Picking up speed. And look at that shot.
After five rounds, the South is up by 20 points. FCA North point leader Harry Trainer with 22 points and FCA South point leader John Haney with 20 points have earned the spots in our Belfour Up and In playoff. Find out who'll take home the trophy when Winning Golf returns.
The new 2023 GMC Sierra AT4X is equipped to conquer the great outdoors. Or the great indoors. Welcome to the peak of premium off-roading. Or get 0.9% APR plus 2,500 trade assistance on 2023 Sierra Denali 5.3-liter V8 light-duty models.
Prizes for winning golf contestants provided by Bushnell, the number one laser rangefinder in golf, Bushnell. Vokey SM9 wedges, choose closer, Vokey SM9 wedges. And by Ahead, advanced headwear, embroidery, and design, Ahead. Outerwear provided by FootJoy. FootJoy Performance Outerwear. Layer up with FootJoy. Welcome back to Winning Golf. We're all set for our Belfour Up and In playoff. Belfour Property Restoration. Restoring more than property.
We are on the 18th green at Applecross Country Club, and our top overall point leaders from each FCA team will compete in our final event, the Belfour Up and In playoff. Now, the rules for the playoff are simple. Whoever gets their ball into the cup in the fewest number of strokes will be awarded 25 points for their team. After five rounds, the South team has totaled 70 points, and the North team is right behind with 50 points. So both teams are very much alive. Our first shot will be a 75-foot downhill chip from the rough. John Haney from the FCA team will have the honors. John has chosen a 54-degree wedge, and let's see what happens. This looks like a beautiful touch. This is moving downhill from left to right. And look at this amazing shot by John Haney. And that is winning golf under a lot of pressure. Well done, John Haney. Well, this is an up-and-in contest, so certainly Harry is still alive. Harry Trainer from the FCA North team will try and battle this pristine 18th green here at Applecross Country Club. Harry has chosen a 56-degree wedge, and let's see what he can do. With the camera rolling, this looks like another beauty.
moving from left to right, coming down the hill. And look at these two guys under pressure. This got a chance to go in. Harry Trader, it's in the cup. The FCA North is our winning golf champions with an unbelievable finish here at Applecross Country Club. It doesn't get any better than that. Harry Trainer, congratulations to you and your FCA North team. You are our 2023 winning golf champions. And my goodness, you had a magical performance. And your players hit the pressure shots when it counted. That's what champions do. But most importantly, Harry, I just hope you had a great day and a lot of fun competing with the other players.
I did, Doug. Thank you. That was a great time. I was very thankful for having my FCA North team going against the South team. We did have some great shots, and I look forward to be here next year.
Awesome, my friend. Well, congratulations again, and don't forget, keep up your great work with the FCA.
Oh, I promise I will.
You got it, my friend. Well, whatever you do, don't touch that remote. We'll be right back with the very exciting trophy presentation when Winnie Golf returns.
The new 2023 GMC Sierra AT4X is equipped to conquer the great outdoors or the great indoors. Welcome to the peak of premium off-roading. Or get 0.9% APR plus 2,500 trade assistance on 2023 Sierra Denali 5.3-liter V8 light-duty models.
You'll never experience a hotel quite like the Desmond Malvern, a DoubleTree by Hilton. Now you can enjoy a fully renovated hotel with the same great service and staff, as well as our popular two on-site restaurants and pub. Our distinct banquet spaces can accommodate all sizes for any special occasion. The Desmond is also home to the only IACC-certified conference center in the area. The Desmond Malvern, a DoubleTree by Hilton, where you can get your Hilton Honor Points and a cookie, too.
Welcome back to Winning Golf. Well, Coach Neef, I'd like to congratulate you and your FCA North team. You are our 2023 Winning Golf champions. And I would like Phil Over, our FCA director here in Chester County, to present you with the championship trophy.
Thanks,
Phil?
Jordan. Well, Coach Gibson, normally at the time, this is coming over you, but this comes to you after working for all those years. Great work on pulling your team through, Coach Neef. Well done. Well
Thanks,
done.
Phil. Thanks, Phil.
Our 2023 yeah. winning golf champion, the FCA yeah. North yeah. team. Yeah. Well, Coach Neef, you got to the top of the mountain today. Congratulations. You led the team as usual. Your team hit the pressure shots when it counted. And I just hope you all had a wonderful memory participating on winning golf today.
Doug, thanks for the opportunity. And it's all about you guys having a great day. Thank the Lord for the beautiful weather. And Paul, we got it.
Thank you, Coach Neef. Well, Coach Gibson, as usual, a wonderful job of coaching. Your FCA South team battled throughout the morning. They did very, very well. And I just hope you and your team had a wonderful experience with winning golf.
Oh, we sure did. We had a blast today. It was a lot of fun. We had great memories that we made today, and we appreciate everything from winning golf. Congratulations, Bob. I'll see you again next year.
Thanks, buddy.
Well, thank you, Coach Gibson. Well, I hope all of you enjoyed our very special FCA event today from the amazing Applecross Country Club. I would like to thank our FCA director, Phil Over, as well as all of our sponsors, coaches, players, and volunteers for making this FCA event a very, very special one. And finally, I'd like to thank all of you for watching Winning Golf, the show where, as you know,
everybody wins!
You heard them, where everybody wins. I'll see you all next week.